Okay, the vibes sound great, so I can do this. So it's kind of nice to have something to think about each week. You know, a lot of times we go out to clubs and we get to try things out, and I don't think I necessarily try things out when you're doing a concert and people are just quiet and staring at you. I kind of, except for like improv stuff, I like to have things worked out, but I've been practicing all these things that for me are challenging, and I thought I would play these tunes that are especially challenging for me for different reasons. I don't know. Do I talk? I don't know if I talk about the reasons or not. Let me just play one and see what happens. Okay. Maybe I talk after. Let's see.
Okay.
What do you think? Why do you think I played that tune? For me, it's really challenging. Time is always challenging for me. Time is always something I have to think about. So hopefully, I held the tempo steady. I like to pick a tune where I play as little as I can. That's kind of my kick these days. I wanted to do the sword do. So all my Brazilian friends might think I'm cool for a minute, and then I'll do something to sound American, and they'll be like, oh, okay, he's not cool. Yeah, that's it. I'm always interested in how little I have to play to make harmony work. I don't know if it sounds good or not. I like it, and I like studying it. Okay, so there's that one. Let's see here. I have my list in my head. This one's kind of interesting. I usually pick a tune a week to do like this for a whole bunch of reasons. Let's see here. Thank you. Okay, that's the one I curse at a lot, because I get done and I record into Logic, and I go back and listen to it, and I listen to the beginning, and I listen to the end, and I go see how much faster I got, and I usually say the F word, the S word, there's many of those things that I can say, and we were talking on Vi's workshop about not being hard on yourself when you record, and you shouldn't be, but that's a tune where I am hard on myself. But it's great because I try to play lines, I try to make harmony work. I always feel funny talking about it because now I'm going to go back and listen to it, and if it doesn't sound good, I'm going to feel stupid for talking about it, but that's okay. That's okay. Let's do the next one. Okay. Okay, that's challenging because you don't want ballads to go on too long. So I want to keep playing. I keep coming up with ideas, and then you realize that everyone's getting bored, and you're being self-indulgent. So I think I could have done maybe a little less, but I think it was cool what I did. Sometimes I look and it goes on for 10 minutes when I record it, and I just think, okay, well, that's me just working stuff out. What do I do when I'm in front of people? I heard some good versions. We're all playing Recordeme today, and I think I will finish up with Recordeme. How am I doing on time? Not that it matters. I can't see. It doesn't matter. And I'll finish up on with Recordeme. That's kind of cool to go back and listen to all the different versions of everybody. So thank you. Thanks, Haka. Thanks, David. Thanks, Rusty. Thanks, Chen Chen. It's great. It's a great day. It's kind of cool to just see everybody doing their thing and how they do it. All right. Okay, the last tune is always really interesting to me because if I do okay, you know, if you ever read the Inner Game of Tennis, you have voice one and voice two. Well, the last tune, if I did okay, voice two comes in and says, wow, you did pretty good. You didn't make any mistakes, or maybe you made a couple. Good, I hope you don't mess this up. And that's what I'm always battling with on usually the last tune. Okay. That was fun. It's fun doing this. It's fun having something to do being quarantined, and it's fun getting to practice as much as we all are, I think. And that's it for my part. Stay tuned. David Friedman is at the top of the hour.